since there was so much to dissect from week one in the NFL kickoff weekend, I want three things from week one that will resonate for the rest of the season. So, first things first, Monday night Mannings. So Eli and Peyton Manning hit the ESPN2 airwaves in their inaugural Monday Night Football simulcast, and I don't really know how I feel about it. Was it different? Yes. Was it a little too different? Also maybe yes, but that being said, I think they still could be onto something. I think we gotta give them the benefit of the doubt here. This is their first time doing this. They gotta work out the kinks a little bit, see what works, what doesn't work for them. But there were definitely some standout moments. I mean, whether it was the unique pro level inside or even just some funny brother to brother comedy back and forth. Lorenzo, do you see this being a regular thing for NFL broadcasts? How'd you feel about it?
Yeah, I low-key love this, but is it the future of NFL broadcasts? I actually think yes and no. Things like this, I think, will have a place on the secondary networks, the ESPN2s, the CBS Sports networks, FS1s of the world. But fans of the teams playing in the games never want this to be the only option to watch. But if you have no horse in the race and you're just looking to drop in, especially when the matchup isn't sexy, why wouldn't you want this? All that said, some of it was overproduced because we don't need Peyton asking questions that are way too forced. So, free advice to all the folks at ESPN. Let these guys do their thing, because when it came organically, we got John Harbaugh PB&J stories and got to be a fly on the wall with some of the game's greatest, talking ball as if they were sitting at a bar.
Yeah, and as much of a win as it was for ESPN and the Mannings in week one, things aren't always as clear as we think they are after week one in the NFL. So for thing number two, I call this mulligans and mirages. So Lorenzo, which teams need a mulligan and are better than what they showed?
Yeah, forget a mulligan. The Packers are going to want to leave the course, go home, take a nap, come back later, buy new clubs maybe. This team is definitely better than it looked, but there are some serious problems they need to work out. I'm not worried about Aaron. He'll bounce back. That defense, though. And the Bills. Yes, this looked like a team that read all the offseason predictions. They'll be better. Josh Allen will be better. But that offensive line needs to be better. Though, now that I think about it, last week on this here show, I was the one who picked the Packers to beat the Bills in Super Bowl 56. So maybe I'm the one who needs a mulligan.
Yeah, so you gave out your mulligans, but how about the teams that look better than you think they'll be? Which teams are going to be mirages of week one?
Yeah, I'm going to put Pittsburgh on there, because as nice as that defense looked against Josh Allen, the Steelers just won't be able to rely on a block punt return for a touchdown and constant pressure week in and week out. At some point, that offense needs to step up, and I don't trust that they ever will. The Eagles, they've improved, but not as much as I think it looked like against a Falcons team that needs some serious help everywhere. And I love the Cardinals, but are they that good? I'm not saying they're a mirage just yet, as much as a whole. I want to see some consistency from this Cards team before I really put them in the Super Bowl contender category.
So for our last thing, who are the teams we know will be in the Super Bowl conversation this year after 1 week of play?
Yeah, I think the teams we know are going to be in there are the Chiefs, the Rams, the Bucks, and I'll throw the Saints in there because Sean Payton is a damn wizard. But hell, even in a loss, I love what the Cowboys showed. As long as they have Dak, I think we'll have a shot.
Yeah, and also, what a good weekend it was to be a recycled quarterback in the NFL. We have Sam Darnold and Matthew Stafford, and the craziest one of all, in my opinion, was seeing Jameis Winston just prove redemption is possible in a different system. Hey, sports fans, if you want to watch more sports seriously, be sure to check out these clips right here. And make sure you're subscribed to the channel to see all the great content from us here at USA Today Sports.